In this calculus tutorial, I would like to show you guys one super easy way to understand what's going on with the chain rule when we take the derivative. And here I have two examples for you guys. Let's do the first one. We will differentiate the square root of x to the third power plus x to the second power and then minus 1. This is how we do it. Notice that we have an inner function, which is that, right? Square root of this. Let me break it down for you. The outer function is a square root. I will call that f. It's just square root of a box, like this. Literally a box, just draw a box right here. And then the inner function, we label that as g, and we'll just write that down, which is x to the third power plus x to the second power and then minus 1. Now, we're just going to forget about this, just focus on that. Ask yourself, what's the derivative of square root of a box? 1 over 2 square root of a box. So right here, we have f prime. You can write this as to the 1 half power, but you will deal with square root a lot, so just remember it. We get 1 over 2 square root of a box, right? And then, let's just focus on g and take the derivative. G prime, the derivative of that, is just going to be 3x squared plus 2x. Yes, two terms. Now, we are going to put g, this thing inside of the box, and then multiply by g prime. And remember, it has two terms, so just put down a parenthesis right here. So the derivative for this is going to be 1 over 2 square root. Don't put down the box anymore. Just write that down. X to the third power plus x squared minus 1. Then times this. So multiply by 3x squared plus 2x. That's pretty much it. Of course, you can put that on the top, and I will do that for you guys. 3x squared plus 2x all over 2 square root of x to the third power plus x squared minus 1, and then we are done. So just like that. Now for the second one, we have secant to the fourth power x, and we have to understand this kind of notation really well. This really means we are going to differentiate secant x inside and then raise to the fourth power. So we have the inner function being secant x, so it's a box to the fourth power. So let me break it down. F is just a box to the fourth power, and the inside function is secant x. Break it down, it's easier, less intimidating. Focus on this right here. Take the derivative, just the power rule, 4 box to the third power, done. And then look here, take the derivative. Okay, what's the derivative of secant x? Do you remember this? If you don't, here are some tips, right? Check out the video in the description. I have some tips for you. The derivative of secant, it first repeats, so secant x. And the derivative. And in calculus, secant and tangent are best friends, so you also invite tangent right here as well. So the derivative of secant x is secant x times tangent x. And then put this in the box, multiply, you're done. So this is going to be, I'll just put an equal sign. Here we have 4. Don't draw a box, draw parentheses for the final answer. Write down secant x to the third power. That's that first part. And then we multiply by this. Secant x and then tangent x. Finally, we see that we have secant x to the third power and then secant to the first power. These two together, we can write the s to the fourth power. So we have 4 and then secant to the fourth power x. And then we attach that tangent x. And we're done. Okay. So hopefully this right here can make the chain rule more clear. And of course, I know chain rule is the hardest topic in calculus differentiation up to this point. So make sure you practice that a lot. And then I have two videos for you guys. One is how to take the derivative with the chain rule one time. And the other one is take the derivative with the chain rule twice. Make sure you master them first before you continue the other derivative techniques. That's it.